on 12th of March 1993, there was a series of 13 bomb blasts in Bombay, in which more than 250 innocent citizens of Bombay were killed. More than 250 innocent human beings were killed. And more than 700 human beings were injured. The opposition said, oh, planned everything. Justice Shri Krishna said, it was not meticulously planned, it was a retaliation. More than 1,500 innocent Muslims killed in riots in Bombay. More than 1,500 innocent Muslims during the Bombay riots of December 92 and January 93 were killed. It was a retaliation. And the authorities and the police said it was done by Muslim underworld with the help of some others. That's how the bomb blast took place. And they say, all of them agreed, even the police commissioner, they agreed that it was a retaliation to what had happened in Bombay. We know that immediately after the riots of December 92 and January 93, it was difficult for the Muslims to walk on the streets. It was difficult for him to travel in the train, travel in the bus, to work in a non-Muslim area. They were looked down upon, they were ridiculed. Immediately after 12th March 93 bomb blast, those scenario changes. Most of the Muslims, they know that killing innocent people is prohibited. Yet, they had a soft corner for these people who did the bomb blast. They were happy internally. In Islam, two wrongs don't make a right. Islam condemns this act. Killing innocent human being is to be condemned. You cannot kill innocent human being if somebody else has done injustice to you. You can't kill a third person even if you belong to the same community. Islam prohibits that. Whoever did it, whether Muslims or non-Muslims, whoever killed more than 250 innocent human beings on 12th March 1993, Islam condemns it. Most of the Muslims knew that killing innocent people is haram, it is prohibited, yet they were internally happy. But you cannot use wrong means to reach a right goal. You cannot. Islam does not permit that you use a wrong method to reach a right goal. There cannot be any justification. We realize that Muslims are harassed, they were tortured, they were killed, but you can't justify the killing of innocent human beings. Imagine the family of those more than 250 innocent human beings. When they come to know that the Muslims have killed us, they will think, what kind of religion is this? What wrong did they do? Did they harass you? The person who has harassed you, if you catch him and put him to trial and he's a culprit and you punish him, no problem. All religions give you permission. The innocent people killed on the street, what wrong did they do to you? Imagine he will become a permanent enemy of Islam. Islam does not justify the killing of any innocent human being. It is to be condemned. When we realize the chain of sequence of events, who is to be blamed? We come to know that prevention is better than cure. Who is to be blamed? When we see the sequence of events, we come to know that if the opposition politicians, the politician from the opposition party, if they would not have used Babri Masjid and Ram Janmabhoomi issue as a political plank, the Bombay bomb blast in 93 wouldn't have taken place. Later on, the politicians in power, they could have easily prevented the gathering. They could have easily prevented the destruction of the Babri Masjid. Easily. They had the Supreme Court verdict. They had the military, they had the police, but they were afraid that if we do it, we'll lose vote bank. So they let the destruction take place. Second people responsible are the politicians in power. Third people, the innocent Indians, they are instigated against the minority. And they involve in killing of thousands of innocent Muslims. They are too responsible, but they're innocent people. Fourth people responsible is the police. The police could have easily prevented the riots in Bombay or anywhere in India, easily. The normal civilians, we aren't military trained. We cannot fight with the police. It's easy. It's very easy for the police of any city, especially Bombay, to prevent the riots. Very easy. Preventing terrorist attacks is difficult. I'll come to it later on. But riots is very easy. Easy. But they didn't do it. Some were afraid. There were a few who went out of the way and helped the innocent victims. But the majority were silent spectators. Some even were party to it. Some who were silent spectators, they were afraid that if we went against the politician, we would have been transferred. They too are to be blamed. Fourth people to be blamed are the police. Fifth, last, but not the least, the people who committed this bomb blast. Islam does not give permission to use wrong means to reach the right goal. All five categories are to be equally blamed. If you want to stop terrorist attacks, go to the root cause. Stop the injustice. Stop the wrong done to a particular group of people, and terrorism will stop. It is difficult for the police to stop the bomb blast. We know, we understand. It's not easy, it's difficult. But to stop the riots, very easy. Same case. You see, most of the riots that took place in India, they have the same sequence, same people are involved, the details may differ. Same group of people are involved. We have the other example of the Gujarat massacre that started on 27th of February 2002 and went on till March 2002. It was followed after the burning of a single coach of the Sabarmati Express at Godhra on the 26th of February 2002. We know very well, it is nothing hidden. It's an open secret that this train, the bogie that was burned, according to forensic reports, according to circumstantial evidence, it says that the coach was burned from inside. There are several evidences. But everything was planned. It was pre-planned. Muslims were instigated. There was a gathering. But they didn't kill. They didn't kill the innocent people. They say that 59 car sevaks were killed, yet it is to be doubted. Yes, there may be a few people that have been killed. Many people who were thought to be killed later on were found alive. So then they kept on changing the statement. So it was an inside job. Babri Masjid inside job, 9/11 inside job, Godhra inside job. Main people to blame, they are the politicians. Then immediately, next day, from 27th of February 2002, no retaliation, pre-planned. It was a state-supervised massacre of the innocent Muslims in Gujarat. Nothing spontaneous, all pre-planned. And innocent citizens of Gujarat, they were instigated. They were given money, you can see evidence, to kill thousands of innocent Muslims. According to the state of Gujarat, 793 Muslims were killed and 253 Hindus were killed. But according to several human rights organizations, they said approximately 2,000 to 2,500 innocent human beings were killed. Almost all of them, they were Muslims. Other reports say that more than 5,000 innocent Muslims were killed. There were thousands of Muslim women who were raped. There were tens of thousands of Muslims who were asked to leave the house. The houses were looted. They were burnt. There were tens and thousands of Muslims whose places of business, they were burnt. They were completely destroyed. The people killed in Gujarat massacre is far more the number than the 9/11. The loss of the people of Gujarat, if you add it, it is much more than the loss that took place on 9/11. Yet, according to George Bush, the people who did Gujarat massacre, they aren't terrorists. Only if you harm the Americans, then there's a problem. We know that there are tons of evidence in form of literature, newspaper, booklets. You have the Communism Combat. You have videotapes, VCDs, DVDs, actual recordings of the culprits, the people responsible, yet no action taken. Even the judiciary system, I'm sorry to say, in Gujarat failed. I think they were pressurized by the politicians. So much so that the Supreme Court of India had to pass a remark against the High Court of Gujarat that they were biased and the trials weren't correct. I feel it was mainly the politicians, the Supreme Court,